Welcome to ScholarX YouTube channel. To receive all the neat PG preparation videos, don't forget to subscribe our ScholarX YouTube channel. Click on subscribe button and don't forget to press bell icon.
Today we will talk about bilirubin cycle. The basic component of bilirubin cycle is heme. The source for heme are three structures, which are hemoglobin, myoglobin and cytochromes. This heme is present in the blood, which is act upon by an enzyme known as heme oxygenase. Which convert heme into a component known as bilirubin. Bilirubin is act upon by another enzyme known as bilirubin reductase. This enzyme convert bilirubin into bilirubin. Bilirubin bind to the albumin, which is present in the blood, and form a complex known as bilirubin albumin complex. Now this bilirubin albumin complex goes to the hepatocyte, but before go enter into the hepatocyte, albumin is removed from this complex and lastly only bilirubin left behind. So only bilirubin enter into the hepatocyte. So this is a hepatocyte and bilirubin is now inside the hepatocyte. Now there is a conjugation of bilirubin. This conjugation is mediated by an enzyme known as UGT, UDP glucuronolyl transferase enzyme. So it attaches the UDP to the bilirubin and form a component known as conjugated bilirubin. Now this component excreted from the liver by a transporter. This transporter is known as multi drug resistant protein 2, in short form MRP2. So conjugated bilirubin by the help of MRP2 goes into the intestine. This conjugated bilirubin may also go to blood by another transporter known as MRP3, multi drug resistant protein 3. So there's some amount of conjugated bilirubin may also present in the blood, and from the blood it re-enter into the hepatocyte by another transporter known as organic anion transporter, and after entering into the hepatocyte it again goes into the intestine by MRP2, the same protein. So after entering into the intestine, we will look for further conversion of this conjugated bilirubin product. So now we will see the further conversion of conjugated bilirubin inside the intestine. So this is our intestine and the conjugated bilirubin is in the intestine. This conjugated bilirubin is act upon by bacteria which is present inside our gut. The bacteria degrade the UDP, so it removes the conjugation of the conjugated bilirubin. So after removal of the conjugation, this conjugated bilirubin now convert into the component known as urobilinogen. This urobilinogen is a water soluble component, so it can be excreted by the kidney. So here is a point remember to know, that only urobilinogen is present in the blood, never unconjugated bilirubin. So here is the excretion of urobilinogen by the kidney. This urobilinogen can also be enter into the enterohepatic cycle and may again go to the liver, and the further and the cycle will repeat itself. Again there will be conjugation, again there will be excretion by MRP2, and again it will go to the intestine. This urobilinogen may also convert into the stercobilinogen, and this stercobilinogen convert into the stercobilin, which excreted into the feces and give the characteristic yellow color to the feces. Thank you.
Welcome to ScholarX YouTube channel. To receive all the neat PG preparation videos, don't forget to subscribe our ScholarX YouTube channel. Click on subscribe button and don't forget to press bell icon.